of indirect action and action together. But the commitment to the society, in smaller terms, when your neighbor's child is sick, or your neighbor's mother has died, something, whatever, that neighbor is in an emotional turmoil, that support that you give is your social commitment. These four commitments, these four aspects of your life, if you fulfill in a balanced way, your quality of life as an individual in a society comes up. Your society comes up as a happy individual, as a happy family, as a happy community that lives, works and produces together. Never forget this. Each of these things is important. Don't work for 18 hours at the cost of your family. Don't work for 18 hours at the cost of your community. You must work in a setup where you can contribute to that. Fortunately, I have worked in a setup where many of these things were possible. I could, in the thickest of my inspection times, with the commander-in-chief coming, I could tell my boss, sir, my neighbor, Lieutenant so-and-so wife is sick, I need to take her to the hospital. I could do it, and moreover, my office will even give me a transport to do it. That is the kind of community spirit that I have gone through. That is why I am telling you the value of this. Again, I have been fortunate. The Navy has given immense chances to use one's own talents, sports facilities, anything. We used to have a lot of get-togethers, we used to ease out, hear music, lot of things. Every other part of it was fulfilled. Therefore it was very, very, the quality of life in this kind of situation was very high. I was lucky because I didn't get through a long process of war and endless amount of that kind of situation. We lived in a peacetime, comparatively. So this is one thing about the quality of life. The other thing that I have been sharing with some of you is the thing of work itself. Today I will talk to you not as students. I will tell you what I as a father have told my own children. I will speak in no other tone. Because work, the work of an individual comes, each of these things are fine. The social commitment, the family commitment, the ability to have a long lot of enjoyment and involvement in your interests, all this is fine. But an individual sense of worth comes from the work that he or she does. And the work itself has got four components. You think everything has got four? I don't know, but these are the four things that I noticed. The first part, first two parts are physical and an intellectual component. Physical component means your ability to do things, your ability to put things together, your ability to organize, your ability to actually use your body, its abilities, your feet, your mind, a good dressing, all these things, the physical components of every aspect of your personality that you use at work. The other thing is the intellectual component, every bits of imagination, every bits of innovation that you can bring about, a due thought, a lateral thought, a creativity which you can transform into a certain kind of product, all these things, that's the intellectual component. Then there is an emotional component, the attachment you have with your work, with its outputs, that it succeeds, that it does what it is, what you have intended that it should do. The emotional component with your mates at work, the bonding between workmates. Just for a short interlude, they say that from times immemorial, the women used to stay and look after the society where the children grew, the homestead, the cooking of food, whereas men used to go out for work. There was a certain kind of bonding with the women who used to do this together. There was a certain kind of bonding among the men who used to do it. As families in ancient times, they didn't exist too much, more as communities. Later on, the families came as joint families and now the nuclear families. But the tendency to keep bonding, somehow it seemed to have reduced among the women folk because the homestead is being less maintained by the women folk rather than by, say, the nuclear family or the joint family. But the women folk also have stepped into the men's shoes. They are going out to equivalent to what was hunting those days. They are going out to work. They are going out to a joint production, which is for a community. So therefore, they are going a different mode of operation. And then, like they said, I need some time to be with the boys. So the girls also have now require the time to be out with the girls and the boys. It is a work company. It is where you put all your skill, your teamwork and all those things. There's a bonding to that team, where you work, where you apply your skills, where you apply your mind, where you apply your energy. So that is that emotional component and the value with which you have for your work. The fourth one is a spiritual component. Now, I'm not talking about spirit in terms of God or anything. I am, in a certain sense, I am an agnostic. Not in a certain sense, I am an agnostic. Do you know what is an agnostic? A believer is a theist. A non-believer is an atheist. Agnostic is a person who is not concerned about the presence or the absence of God. That is an agnostic. In a sense, I have lived like that. I have never, from my 6th, 7th standard, from my school days, I think the last time I went to a temple for a prayer or something was in my 6th standard. I have never gone in for a prayer. But I have gone in for a community purpose. I have gone with my sister, with my wife, with my mother, with whoever goes for that purpose. And I respect their beliefs. It is up to them. But I myself do not have any belief either this way or that. So what I am trying to say is that the spiritual component which I am talking about is not any way related to that. But it is related to these seeking questions that perspectives in life principle. To a complete perspectives in life principle. What is my action? What is the impact of my action? When I see it, how do I respond? I am so busy, I have to organize this function today. I am coming here, driving on my way to this place. I find a child being hit or something, being abused by somebody on the road. My heart goes out to it. What do I do? Does my work has that necessary wherewithal? Do I have the wherewithal to do something for the child? Or is my work, like I said, every bit of, much of what we do goes ultimately in creating this economy through the mode of consumption of resources for various ends, whatever. These are questions that I have to ask myself. And I will tell you honestly that my life in the Navy was intellectually challenging. It was very physically challenging, physically, intellectually and emotionally. It was a huge challenge. It was a huge success. I enjoyed my years of work in the Navy till I grew up to beyond 15, 16 years. You will all come to that stage where the first aspect of work that you see is that physical and intellectual challenges. You tend to forget the other part. But when you grow up, when you see your children, when you see the world that you start creating for them, when you start answering their innocent questions, then few other different aspects of work comes to your mind. And one of the aspects that come when you are 30, 35, 40 is the spiritual component. What is the meaning of your work? What is the end of your work? Is it doing good? Is it doing bad? If it is good, in what form? If it is bad, in what form? If you do not ask this question, if it doesn't occur to you, you have lived your life to a level of insensitivity. You have lived a level of Tamla Swarna Koch. When Swarna is gone, you can neither be happy nor you can be sad. You can be a moron. You will be a machine, you will be anything. Yavano Yada Swarna, you will listen to him if you have a mood. Otherwise, you will not have a listen to him. If you are irritated, you will slap. If you are, if you feel that you should be thrilled, you will go and booch and that kind of insensitivity seeps into the minds of people by the time you are 30, 40. Then you